Russia's lease for a proposed diplomatic site next to Parliament House has been formally blocked thanks to new legislation that passed the Parliament this morning. Our political reporter Olivia Casely joins us live from Canberra. Olivia, it looks like Russian diplomats, though, they can stay in Australia.
Yes, so the Prime Minister this morning confirmed that Russian diplomats will still be able to work in Australia, just as we have Australian diplomats working in Russia. But it's understandably a cause for concern, especially after we learnt last year that ASIO had dismantled this so-called hive of Russian spies who were essentially conducting foreign espionage activities here in Canberra under the pretense of diplomatic activities. Here's the Prime Minister on this issue earlier.
Well, Russia does have a diplomatic presence here, and that will continue at its existing premises in Griffith, just as Australia has a diplomatic presence in Moscow. This is not about changing that. This is about the specific risk presented by this site, and that is why we are taking this action.
Russia's plan to build this controversial second site has now been formally blocked by Parliament. So legislation was introduced this morning and it's passed both the House and the Senate incredibly quickly. It did receive bipartisan support. Now, I just want to show you how close this proposed second site was to Parliament House. If you take a look at this graphic here, it's right next to the Chinese embassy. It looks like basically a stone throws away from Parliament House. So you can really understand the national security concerns. Now, last year, the National Capital Authority had already blocked the building of the site, and then Russia essentially took legal action through the federal court. That's why we've seen the introduction of this legislation this morning, Ash.
Olivia Casely in Canberra, thank you.